Tornado? Engage.
Kit, come here. I need you.
Scotty?
Expedio mobile.
Harry, wir brauchen den Wagen. Harry. Hallo?
Kommissar Derek.
Commissar Derek, or Inspector Derek to some, he's still one of the most popular TV detectives in the world. The series has been broadcast in over 100 countries, but mobility is not a problem for him. He just calls his assistant, Harry, who then brings the car around. Captain Kirk from the Star Trek series preferred a different form of transport. Beam me up, Scotty, and off he went to unknown galaxies at the speed of light. But then, as we've just seen a moment ago, it's better not to rely on that. And it's for that reason, tonight, we're going to present you with a different form of individual mobility. And, by the way, we don't need a magic wand for that. We have the one button you just saw in that movie. This one button opens the door to an integrated mobility system of the future, a project which the Volkswagen Group is currently working on. The vision is that one single touch of this button will guarantee individual mobility for everyone, anytime, any place. So, let's just try. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Sedric, the first self-driving car from the Volkswagen Group. It's all electric, fully connected and fully autonomous. Sedric is our foretaste of automated vehicles of the highest stage of automation, also referred to as level 5. So Sedric independently performs all driving functions, it's smart and very easy to operate. A steering wheel, pedals and a cockpit are no longer needed. Sedric has been systematically developed to meet users' needs. You just touch the one button and the car drives up. It recognizes you, the door opens, you can get in, you stow your bags, and take a seat. And from now on, you talk to Sedric just like you would normally to your personal assistant, if you will. All further communications, where you want to go, how long the journey will take, what you can expect to find there, all of that is voice controlled. And you choose whether Sedric takes you to your destination by the shortest, by the fastest, or by the most scenic route. During the ride, you can then spend your time just as you like. Working, making phone calls, talking to other passengers, or just relaxing, basically. So Sedric then drops you off at your destination and then drives away to either automatically find a parking space or to serve the next passenger. Because Sedric can be used as a shared mobility vehicle from the Volkswagen Group pool, but it can equally well be your own, your personal car. Because many of our customers will continue to own a car in future too, but they can still share this car whenever they like, with their family and friends or other people living in their neighborhood. Ladies and gentlemen, it was this time last year here in Geneva that we talked about how fully automated vehicles will make life in our cities better, greener, above all safer. Because that is what it is, this self-driving car. It's always wide awake, it's never distracted, it's never tired. And the technological heart that makes all that possible is our self-driving system. This is a system based on artificial intelligence. It uses 360-degree LiDAR lasers, radar systems, numerous cameras. It uses high-end ultrasound sensor technologies and highly accurate digital maps. And these digital maps can also be updated in real time with the help of crowd data. The data are then transmitted to a very compact control unit. Until a few years ago, you would have to use supercomputers, mainframes the size of a sports hall, that would have been needed to provide such processing power as this control unit. And of course, Sedric is emissions-free, drives silently thanks to its battery-powered drive. The technical backbone of that system is our MEB, the Modular Electric Drive Kit, which is the foundation for future generations of our all-electric cars here in the Volkswagen Group. The battery unit is flat-mounted between the axles. The compact electric motor is fitted between the wheels. And as a result, we do no longer need the traditional proportions of present-day vehicles. Sedric's monolithic base does away with these common elements as a bonnet or a shoulder line, and I hope you'll agree with me when I say that this design is still friendly, it's appealing, it's positive. The 2+2 seat interior has been designed to maximize interior space and to minimize footprint, and the wheelbase, as you see, is almost identical with a VW up. Still, Sedric creates a feeling of plenty of space, like a comfortable lounge on four wheels. It's fitted out with plenty of elements that make autonomous mobility truly fun. Ladies and gentlemen, there is also another reason why Sedric is something special. It's the first concept car from the Volkswagen Group. Now, to avoid misunderstandings, the group will not be building its own cars in the future, of course. That is something that our brands excel in. But this concept car stands for a new self-image of ours. The Volkswagen Group is a catalyst, an incubator for ideas. It looks far into the future. It brings together the creativity, the competence, and the knowledge of our group family. And then, obviously, shares all that with its brands. And that way, we can deliver innovations to our customers even faster in the future. Sedric was conceived, developed and built at the Volkswagen Group Future Center in Potsdam in collaboration with our group research in Wolfsburg. And Sedric's creators are with us this evening, Johann Jungwirth, the Volkswagen Group's Chief Digital Officer, Ulrich Eichhorn, Head of Research and Development, and Michael Mauer, Head of Group Design. Many thanks to you and, first of all, of course, your entire team. You've done a great job.
technical challenge was twofold. It was to cover all the situations with the sensors, with the algorithms, with the driving situations, which is very complicated. And at the same time, making it very, very easy and simple for the driver, the customer, the person being chauffeured. On one button and just voice commands, making the vehicle drive and do what you want. At the same time, in the background, it must be able to cover all conceivable situations. And that was the technically tricky part. And we've been working on this in Volkswagen, not for the last 2 or 3 years. This is a 1-year project in itself, but we've been working on this for more than 20 years. Sedric, as we see it here, is a show car, is a vision, is a car that we show as the Volkswagen Group. Ultimately, it will see production in one of the brands and being used either for customers as their own car, owned mobility, or in shared car services, shared mobility. This will happen within the next 5 to 10 years. We will be launching with the ID in about 2020. Which shares the technical basis as a car, and this will come somewhat after it, depending entirely on how the business models for such vehicles develop. Well, in principle, we have all the building blocks in place. We have the sensors, we have different sensor principles on here, we have the algorithms that build the world picture in which the car navigates, we also have the algorithms that drive the car. However, we still have to add to situations and rules and algorithms for behaving in certain driving situations. We also have to develop things further for reliability and safety. And we have to make especially the sensors a lot cheaper so that they can be sold in a Golf class car.
For me, this is a historical day. So we created a completely new mobility concept and of course with self-driving automobiles without a steering wheel and pedals. And this is the Volkswagen button, which you can use to actually call Sedric. And to call your personal individual self-driving automobile to bring you from A to B, and I have to say this is the future for me. We are working, of course, through our brands, with individual designs and interior concepts and so on to bring Sedric to life into markets. But I have to say, cars or vehicles, self-driving cars without steering wheel and pedals are absolutely realistic. And for me, this is, like the reinvention of the automobile, basically like the switch from horses to cars at that time. Studies have been performed throughout the world, and the acceptance is already today, quite high. It's partially double, higher in countries like India or China and in Asia in general, but even here in Europe, it's quite high. And what we see is that as people get used to this, the trust in this technology and the self-driving system, goes up very, very steeply.
With this car, for the first time, we were really able to use all the new possibilities based on the fact that the technology is now very much in the background. So from the architecture, from the proportion, this car is really setting a new standard. With Sedric, it is much more than just a car. It is really a user experience. It starts with the way how I order the car, how I enter the car. There's no steering wheel, there's no pedal anymore, there is no driver anymore. It is self-driving. I have a completely new experience when it comes to the roominess. So all the things we know from means of transportation of today have changed with this concept. Yeah, I strongly believe that it is the golden age for designers, since for the first time, you could say, in the car history, things are really changing dramatically. So if it is the package, all these requirements and restraints we had so far are disappearing. It opens up for completely new possibilities. And as a designer, you have the possibility to visualize all these ideas for the future. And therefore, I really think that we will play a key role in this new age.